Lord, we thank you so much for gracing our presence every time. We thank you that you are our God. We thank you for Jesus, for the Holy Spirit. Father, be with us now. Grant us favor. Let the listeners receive exactly the way you gave it. In Jesus' name we pray and we thank you. I was reading the word the other morning. I was reading about the man born blind in John 9, 1 through 5. Let me just read it to you. Now, as Jesus passed by, he saw a man who was born blind from birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, "Neither this man nor his parents sinned, but that the works of God should be revealed in him. I must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. The night is coming when no man can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world." Hollywood vision. On any other day, I probably wouldn't have stopped. Like the majority of the people on the busy avenue, I would hardly have noticed him standing there. But the very thing on my mind that morning was the very reason he was there. So I stopped. I just spent a portion of the morning preparing a lesson out of the 9th chapter of John, the chapter that contains the story about the man blind from birth. I'd finished lunch and was returning to the studio, and I saw him. He was singing. An aluminum cane was in his left hand. His right hand was extended and open, awaiting donations. He was blind. After walking past him 5 steps or so, I stopped and mumbled something to myself about being a hypocrite, and I went back in his direction. I put some change in his hand. "Thank you," he said, and then offered me a common salutation. "And may you have health." Ironic wish, I thought. Once again, I started on my way. Once again, the morning study of John 9 stopped me. Now, Jesus saw a man blind from birth. I paused and pondered. If Jesus were here, he would see this man. I wasn't sure what that meant, but I was sure I hadn't done what that meant. So I turned around again. As if the giving of a donation entitled me to do so, I stopped beside a nearby car and observed. I challenged myself to see him. I would stay here until I saw more than a sightless indigent on a busy thoroughfare in downtown Hollywood. I watched him sing. Now, some beggars grovel in a corner cultivating pity. Others unashamedly lay their children on blankets in the middle of the sidewalk, thinking that only the hardest of hearts would ignore a dirty, naked infant asking for bread. But this man did none of that. He stood tall, and he sang loudly, even proudly. All of us had more reason to sing than he, I thought, but he was the only one singing. Mainly he sang folk songs. Once I thought he was singing a hymn, though I wasn't sure. His husky voice was so out of place amid the buzz of commerce, like a small sparrow who found his way into a noisy factory or a lost fawn on an interstate. His singing conjured an awkward marriage between progress and simplicity. The passers-by had various reactions. Some were curious and gazed unabashedly. Others were uncomfortable. They were quick to duck their heads and walk in a wider circle. "No reminders of harshness today, please." Most, however, hardly noticed him. Their thoughts were occupied, their agendas were full, and he was a blind beggar. I was thankful he couldn't see the way they looked at him. After a few minutes, I went up to him again. "Have you had any lunch?" I asked. He stopped singing and turned his head toward the sound of my voice and directed his face somewhere past my ear. His eye sockets were empty. He said he was hungry. I went to a nearby restaurant and bought him a sandwich and something cold to drink. When I came back, he was still singing and his hands were still empty. He was grateful for the food. We sat down on a nearby bench. Between bites, he told me about himself. 48 years old, single, lives with his parents and 7 brothers. "Were you born blind?" I asked. "No. When I was young, I had an accident." He didn't volunteer details, and I didn't have the gall to request them. Though we were almost the same age, we were light years apart. My 5 decades had been a summer vacation of family excursions, Sunday school occasionally, debate teams, football, and a search for the Almighty. Growing up blind in Hollywood surely offered none of these for him. My daily concern now involved people, thoughts, concepts, and communication. His day was stitched with concerns of survival, coins, handouts, and food. I'd go home to a nice home, a hot meal, a good wife. I hated to think of the home he would encounter. I'd seen enough overcrowded places in Hollywood to make a reasonable guess. And his reception, would there be anyone to make him feel special when he got home? I came whisker close to asking him, "Does it make you mad that you're not me? Do you ever lie awake at night wondering why the hand you were dealt was so different from the millions of hands dealt to millions of other people born 48 or 50 years ago?" I wore a shirt and a tie and some brand new shoes. His shoes had holes and his coat was oversized and bulky. His pants gaped from a rip in the knee. And still, he sang. Though a sightless, penniless hobo, he still found a song and sang it courageously. I wondered which room in his heart that song came from. At worst, I figured he sang from desperation. His song was all he had. Even when no one gave coins, he still had his song. Yet he seemed too peaceful to be singing out of self-preservation. Or perhaps he sang from ignorance. Maybe he didn't know what he never had. No. I decided the motivation that fit his demeanor was the one you'd least expect. He was singing from contentment. Somehow, this eyeless pauper had discovered a candle called satisfaction, and it glowed in his dark world. Someone had told him, or maybe he told himself, that tomorrow's joy is fathered by today's acceptance. Acceptance of what? At least for the moment. The acceptance of what you cannot alter. I looked up at the Niagara of faces that flowed past us. Grim, professional, some determined, some disguised, but none were singing, not even silently. What if each face, I thought, were a billboard that announced the true state of its owner's heart? How many would say desperate, business on the rocks, or broken, or in need of repair, or faithless, frantic, and fearful? Quite a few. The irony was painfully amusing. The blind man could be the most peaceful fella on the street. No diploma, no awards, and no future, at least in the aggressive sense of the word. But I wondered how many in that urban stampede would trade their boardrooms and blue suits in a second for a chance to drink at this young man's well. Faith is a bird that sings while it is in the dark. Before I helped my friend back to his position on the street, I tried to verbalize my empathy. Life is hard, isn't it? A slight smile came on his face. He again turned his face toward the direction of my voice and started to respond, and then paused and said, "I'd better get back to work." For almost a block, I could hear him singing, and in my mind's eye, I could still see him. But the man I now saw was different, was a different one than the one to whom I'd given a few coins. Though the man I now saw was still sightless, he was remarkably insightful. And though I was the one with eyes, it was he who gave me a new vision that day. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.